Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whenever you are watching this. In a democracy, in a welfare state, there are three sectors which are so important that they can't be left to the mercy of the market forces. One amongst them and most important is health. Two other interconnected are education and food. Unfortunately, health sector is being commercialized. We have been observing the effects of the commercialization of the health sector. Fresh in our memory, the ghastly incidents at Gorakhpur and at Farukabad in quick succession a couple of months ago. The reason for the deaths of 63 children was the non-availability of the oxygen. Oxygen was not supplied, our commercial interest is involved, and that was not kept in readiness, and 63 precious lives were taken. And similar was the incident. Same cause at Farukabad, some 14 children died. So this commercial approach we are seeing, it is for everybody to see the manifestations of the commercialization of the industry. It's not the need that is important for the medical community to treat you. When there is a medical emergency, when you require a surgery or a hospitalization, you do get when you do have money in your pocket. If you have money and if you do not have disease, still then you are admitted and you get treatment which you do not require. Unnecessary surgeries are conducted, unnecessary tests are conducted to the persons who do not require them at all, but for who require them at once, they do not get them because they do not have money. How the system is emerging? See, there are really strange things happening in this sector. See, for tests, a doctor writes a battery of tests. They are not required. Of them, only one test is marked. So this test which is marked is called marker test. That test is taken care by the diagnostic center, and they only do that test and give value for that, and the other tests, what doctors write, they draw the sample. For example, blood. They take blood for as many tests as are scribbled by the doctor. But after that, they give only normal results for all those tests which they never conduct. And they throw the extra blood that they have drawn from human beings into the sink. That's how the test is called sink test. And the marker test, which is marked. The gullible people do not know what is happening to them. Then in this country, prenatal sex determination is an illegality. But how many are following this? They do this and they again have their own subtle methods to convey this, to evade the law, legal provisions. They call Ganesh if there is a birth, going to be a boy baby, they say it is Ganesh. If it is going to be a girl baby, they call it Lakshmi. The hint is given to them. And those who are interested in knowing this before birth of a child, to kill the child, that you know the female child are not wanted in this country. That is why the legality has come, and then no doctor is bothered about this. Those who are involving in this, that money is more important to them than anything else. And the surgeries are also conducted which are not necessary. And surgeries are also performed which are not necessary if you have money to get them performed. If you are covered by an insurance scheme, if your employer pays for that, if you do have money by yourself, whatever the source, they are not bothered about. But if you go with full money, if you do not have any disease, they are conducted. For instance, people often do not require hysterectomy. Do not require, natural birth is necessary, is enough. Natural birth is enough, but most women do not require cesarean section. Cataract surgery, people are afraid something has happened to me. This is another surgery. Why I am listing, these are the surgeries which are routinely performed by the doctors for money. The knee replacement, kneecap replacement. These are kind of surgeries which they are doing because the health sector has been commercialized and they are working for the money. The pharmaceutical industry gifts the doctors to lure them to prescribe the medicines of the industry, that particular company. They not only go costly gifts, at times they sponsor the foreign trips of the doctors. Not only of the doctors, but their family members. 5-star accommodations are provided to them. Then what kind of medicines will they write? Then, for referring to another doctor, an expert who gives more money, who shares more money with the person who is referring to him, gets more referrals than the others. Fee split. There are business targets like any other industry and commerce. Doctors have said that, look, you are getting this much salary a month. You should get this much business, so many times your salary, to justify your continuance in this hospital where I am employing you. Then what the doctors do? They keep on writing these kinds of tests. They keep on treating the people who do not require at the cost of the harm to the people, not to the doctor. This goes on, through which medical industry flourishes. Are there no rules for this? Are there no regulations for this to control the doctors and the sector? The Medical Council of India has prepared an exhaustive list of regulations way back in 2002. Of course, updating time to time. It has listed down all the do's and do-nots for the doctors. It prohibits, naturally, corrupt practices. No doctor should indulge in corruption. Not only that, doctor should not indulge in corruption, but he should not allow others, his colleagues, to indulge into these practices. Every doctor is expected to display in his chamber the fee. The patient should know what amount of fee I am going to pay for this kind of treatment. But how many doctors are doing this? And doctors are expected to be punctual as per MCI regulations. But the patient who is already suffering with the disease has to wait with so much uncertainty that we do not know. They do not know when the doctors will appear, when they visit. There is nobody to oversee the implementation of the regulations painstakingly framed by the MCI. Then no agent is expected to be involved in this profession. There is no solicitation, that's what the MCI rules say. But without doubts, is this business going on and flourishing? The new health policy 2017 really has a sacred goal that there should be highest professional standards. But is this going to happen without addressing the root causes of the disease that has afflicted the medical industry? So without addressing the root causes, why these things are coming? They are only the symptoms, manifestations of the malady. They are to be addressed. So what is the state of the medical industry? How it is flourishing and at what cost? How people are getting poorer, Middle class are also joining the ranks of below poverty line. I will show in part 2 of this episode, with the help of the official data, I will explain the state of the sector. Please watch that. Please watch my channel, PSM Speak. Please click the subscribe button below the video. Alongside, you will also notice the bell icon. Please click it to get the notification as and when I upload videos to this channel. Thank you.